Thursday.
I'm not the only kid who grew up this way. Surrounded by people who used to say that rhyme about sticks and stones. As if broken bones hurt more than the names we got called, and we got called them all. So we grew up believing no one would ever fall in love with us. That we'd be lonely forever. That we'd never meet someone to make us feel like the sun was something they built for us in their tool shed. So broken heartstrings bled the blues as we tried to empty ourselves so we would feel nothing. Don't tell me that hurts less than a broken bone. She was 8 years old. Our first day of grade 3 when she got called ugly. We both got moved to the back of class so we would stop getting bombarded by spitballs. But the school halls were a battleground. We found ourselves outnumbered day after wretched day. We used to stay inside the recess because outside was worse. Outside we'd have to rehearse running away or learn to stay still like statues, giving them clues if we were there in grade 5. They taped a sign to the front of her desk that read, "Beware of the dog." To this day, despite a loving husband, she doesn't think she's beautiful. Kids used to say she looks like a wrong answer that someone tried to erase but couldn't quite get the job done. And they'll never understand that she's raising two kids whose definition of beauty begins with the word mom. Because they see her heart, or they see her skin, but she's only ever always been amazing. We weren't the only kids who grew up this way. To this day, kids are still being called names. Seems like every school has an arsenal of names getting updated every year. And if a kid breaks in school and no one around chooses to hear, do they make a sound? Are they just background noise from a soundtrack stuck on repeat when people say things like, "Kids can be cruel"? Every school was a big top circus tent, and the pecking order went from acrobats to lion tamers, from clowns to carnies. All of these miles ahead of who we were freaks. And if you can't see anything beautiful by yourself, get a better mirror. Look a little closer. Stare a little longer. Because there's something inside you that made you keep trying despite everyone who told you to quit. You built a cast around your broken heart and finding yourself beside it. They were wrong. They have to be wrong. Why else would we still be here? But we are graduating members from the class if we made it. Not the faded echoes of voices crying out names will never hurt me. Of course, they did. But our lives will only ever always continue to be a balancing act that has less to do with pain and more to do with beauty.